How we understand the disease, way we apply this therapeutics. If organism is the cause of the disease, then why all are not getting? How to understand the disease?
This is the principal concept of homeopathy.
There are different understandings about the disease. In the ancient days, people used to understand the disease as a curse of God or with the evil spirits, effect of the evil spirits. Then the people used to resort as a therapeutic method, offering prayers to God to please the God, or else certain rituals to eliminate or throw off this particular devil. So in this way, the therapeutics used to perform. Even now, today, we will see in certain societies, this particular thing is still prevailing. The second is the concept we call the understanding or the concept, the humoral theory. Body is made up of different elements, and the combination and permutation of these will make health. Or the humoral theory, we will call it as different humors, either explained by the Hippocrates or by Ayurveda or Yunani. Different systems believe in this particular humoral theory. The balance of these humors is called health. Imbalance of these humors, they call it as disease. So the therapeutic methods in this particular method, in this particular understanding of humoral theory, they try to correct the humors. So in this way, there are many therapeutics agents or therapeutic which came into the field, medical field, is bloodletting, emetics, starving, or producing the sweat, excessive sweat. In this way, there are so many things they used to perform to correct the humors. Okay, this is one. Then the third is the bacterial concept, or we call it as the germ theory. People understand that for any disease, either virus or bacteria or fungal or some other organism is responsible for this. So kill the germ and cure the disease. So another important thing understanding is the concept that tissue changes. Correction of pathology is the method of therapeutics they used to apply. But all these therapeutics are failed. Now there are so many diseases which are coming, and they are not responding to these therapeutics. Still, they are in search of some other causes. Even now, even today, people are in search of cause of the disease. The tole causa, remove the cause and cure the disease. They are still thinking of, but they are searching causes outside the body. They are thinking these causes are away. They are not understanding the disease is inside. The concept of homeopathy is something different. If you understand the disease properly, then you can apply the therapeutics properly. All these days, so far, the people were not able to understand the disease properly. Some of the people are thinking the disease as an evil causes, or some people are thinking it's a humoral, something people are thinking it as a bacteria or virus, some organism is responsible for the disease, and some of the people, they thought that the disease, the changes
in the tissues and organs is the cause of the disease. Accordingly, they applied different therapeutics, yet they are unable to cure the diseases properly. Still, they are in search. Every time the new concept, new understanding about the disease, they are focusing, and they all those things are getting failed. That's why Hahnemann stressed here, we have to understand the disease properly, so that we can apply the therapeutics properly. The high and only mission of the physician is to restore the sick to health, to cure as it is termed. In whatever the way you have to understand the disease, you have to understand the disease proper. So what is disease is most important. Disease is nothing but the alterations in the vital force. Disease is prior to the tissue changes. If organism is the cause of the disease, then why all are not getting? First aphorism, he says that high and only mission of the physician is to restore the sick to health, to cure as it is termed. He put a star mark and gave some footnote to this as it is termed. So the physician's high and only mission is in that if the organism is the cause, organism is everywhere, it is present in the environment, but all the people are not getting the disease. In some of the cases, there is a plenty of bacteria which is present in the body, but they are unable to produce any symptoms. We will see many carriers, even now the COVID, they will be positive. They have abundant of virus in their body, but they won't suffer with any pathology. Then if that is the cause, if the virus is the real cause of the disease, then why the person is not getting the disease? There are many typhoid people, they pass bacteria in their stool abundantly, but they may never suffer with a typhoid fever or typhoid symptomatology. They call it as a carriers. If bacteria is the real cause, then why they are not suffering? This is the point. So when there is less bacteria, more toxicity, more the bacteria, less the toxicity, why it is happening then? In case of typhoid. So this is, people say it is when bacteria died, we kill them, they release endotoxin. That toxin is responsible for the production of the disease. But this way the people are constructing the theories, false theories about the understanding of the disease. That's why all these therapeutics so far their people were applying in the medical field, they are getting failed. But how to understand the disease? The disease is nothing but a change in the life principle or change in the vital force. The disease is prior to the changes of the tissues and organs. So those are the real diseases. Even if in the case of any bacteria, if they enter into the body, immediately they are not going to get this symptomatology. After some time they are. So they are not producing any pathological changes immediately. But during that time, they are getting some symptoms prior to these tissue changes and organ changes. So whatever the symptoms, those are the real disease, are the symptomatology of the disease.
That is, there is something change, something alterations occurred in you that paving the way to affect any organism, any bacteria, any virus, so that it gives rise to certain symptomatology. So this disease is not, pathology is the end result of the disease. It is not the cause of the disease. So prior to the pathology, there is a symptomatology. That symptomatology is the real nature of the disease. So tissue alterations, organic changes are not the disease. They are the end results of the disease. This is the principal concept of homeopathy. Homeopathy understands disease as a holistic, individualistic. What do you mean by holistic? And what do you mean by individualistic? Example, you have one single cell, a zygote. Because of its ego, its internal life principle, which directs to grow into in a different parts and gives a shape, different organs, different tissues are developing only from single cell. The ego of the cell or the principle of that particular cell, which is underlying that particular, is responsible for the growth of these. So the principle of that particular zygote or that particular life, which we will call it as the life principle, then because of that, that is the most important thing for growth and development of an organism. That principle directs growth and development of organism, and that principle itself is responsible for the maintenance of health, and that principle itself is responsible for disease. The principle, if it's order in harmony, then we will keep it. The disorder of this principle amounts to disease. So the first change occurs in the principle, and then it gives rise certain symptoms which pertains to the whole of the organism. Then after that, the tissue changes and pathology will be the resulting factor. So disease is always prior to the pathology. That is the basic understanding. So we have to treat the disease, not the ultimate. So we have to correct at the level of the principle, not at the level of the tissues and organs. So this is the basic concept, basic understanding. So all these organs, tissues are grown from single cell. They are all in unity. Man is nothing but a union of more than 100 trillions of cells. All the parts are connected, interconnected. They are all governed by the principle of life. So this principle, if it is in harmony, then it is called health. If it is disharmony, then it is called disease. So, when we view a man, when we think of man, it's all its parts put together. We cannot separate it and we cannot see separate things. For the study, for understanding, you may, but for the disease and the growth and development of an organism, or its harmony, we all are united. This is the concept of holistic, we cannot keep one part away and cannot call it as this is separate. So it is healthy. There are many people now we are experiencing. We will go to the hospital, a patient goes to the hospital. Different specialties examine. And they say each system is perfect. But yet the person comes, I am sick. Then they may be referred to the psychiatry. But psychiatry examination also says he is a perfect. Then also the person is feeling sick. What is this? People cannot understand. The present medical scenario cannot understand this, cannot remedy it. But man, all put together, so is a physical, is a mental, and is a social and a spiritual well-being is called health. Any disturbance in this is amount to disease. Just a mere absence of the disease, you cannot call him as healthy. He must be perfectly healthy in all these particular areas. So then only we will call it as healthy. So holistic is an idea that man is not divided into parts and tissues, organs and systems. All these put together we take as one single unit, that is called man. That is the holistic idea. So if any disturbance occurs as a whole, okay, then in each individual, when we examine all the parts put together, when we see each person is something unique and peculiar. Each person is having two eyes, ears and face, the neck, chest, hands, legs, everything, every part is present. But each, when we all be put together, then we see that each person is unique and something peculiar. Not only in their anatomy, in their physiology, they are something unique and peculiar. So each individual ECG is something different, something varying. In that way, any function in the body are anatomically, physiologically, they are something different. When they are affected with the disease, their symptomatology is also something varied. With both the persons are affected with the typhoid, they are suffering with the typhoid fever. The pattern of fever and other general symptomatology is something varies. That variness is responsible to understand the disease of that particular person. So how do you identify? We identify a person with his unique features. That's why we are calling it as we are not going to give importance to the diagnosis. We are giving importance to the symptomatology of that particular individual. This is the unit. This we will call it as individualistic. So this individualistic theory or the understanding of the disease is most important. This individualist concept. Man as a whole is a unit of all the parts put together. This is the holistic. When all the parts are put together, he is unique in his features, either in physiology or in anatomy. In the same manner, when he is diseased, his symptomatology is unique and peculiar to him. So his reaction is something unique. So this uniqueness, and this is the key for homeopathic understanding of the disease. So basing on that, we select the remedy. So if you understand, disease is not pertaining to the parts and the tissues, it is man as a whole, it affects and it produces change in the total person, either in the physical level or the mental level. And whenever it affects an individual, that individual gives rise to some peculiar, unique symptomatology which is peculiar to him, unique to him. So when you understand this way, then whatever the therapeutics, this is the real, this is the real cause, real concept of the disease. So correct that particular principle, then a remedy is to be given to that particular, to correct that particular principle, then only you can cure the disease. So that's why to understand properly disease, disease is affects man as a whole, which is not pertaining to the parts and the organs and tissues, which is the change in the life principle, which is the one understanding. This is the concept. And the second is, whenever it affects a person, it gives right some unique and peculiar symptoms which are very unique to that particular individual. So this is the real concept of the disease.